I know you can hear me! You're finished! You've gone as far as you're gonna go!
Shit, man! It's slippery here! Ah. I don't want to do this anymore, you know? I should use something else. I'm through for this first blood.
Ah. Yeah, but you stop.
Oh, why not?
Visiting somebody around here?
Can you show the autograph on the camera?
Yeah. This way. 30 years later, it's gonna cost $30 million. 30 years later.
To become the senior's activity center, so keeping all the architectural features of what was the sheriff station wasn't really high on the list of volunteers that were turning it into the senior's activity center. So. The building
Sergeant! Oh!
So we are today with the man from Real Places, Matt from UK.
That's right. This is a spot where the actual scene where Rambo's hanging off the rock face. Hervé Atia from on the scene here, who's shooting this video today, he's discovered this place and brought us up here like billy goats. This won't be on your tour guide either when you go to this town of Hope.
It's a special tour for special guys.
Yeah. Special guys. So he's discovered these hooks here.
Yeah.
These little hooks were put in the movie to hold down all the camera equipment from sliding off the rock face. All these patches of moss at the time of filming were very slick. It's dry right now, but it's very slick, and one little movement can send it right off the mountain. So they have these things drilled into the concrete. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool, some remnants.
Like he wants to turn himself in.
There's one man dead. It's not my fault. I don't want any more hurt.
Freeze. Stand right where you are. Give yourself up.
But I didn't do anything.
I'm warning you, boy. Don't make a move. I'll blow your head off.
I didn't do anything.
Welcome you. Weather is spectacular this morning. It's unbelievable. We had a great evening last night on Wallace Street.
Woo!
it was awesome. So on that note, we'd like to. I'm Brian McKinney, by the way, and just a Hope resident, a movie fan, and obviously a fan of the movie, and just a proud member and a proud citizen of the community of Hope. And thank you.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3.
2 meters, 6 feet, right? Yeah. 6 feet and hold on.
$1,000 sunglasses.
Let's start another line, actually.
Yeah. Give a 1, 2, 3.
Okay,
give a 1, 2, 3, and all the flashes. There's a Hervé, yeah, my buddy. Okay.
Where's the cop? Okay. Mark, are you in here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, we are. We're gonna go to the junkyard today. We have to hike up like a half an hour. Up, we found the place. So we have people from Japan, from England, some Rambo fans. Gears left behind. And there is more here. Here we are. Here is the truck is here. Here's a junkyard. Yep, last time we came here with Riggs and Scott, it was raining like hell. And now we have sunny day. Here's a truck. Some pieces are missing, right? Well. A lot of people think that this was a barrel, but it's not a barrel, it's a pipeline. So what I'm gonna do is to reenact the scene from the eyes of Rambo,
You're finished!
So one Rambo,
you've got as far as you're gonna go!
The ears, he will face this way. What does he see? He's gonna see the trailer here. And he's gonna come here, inside this trailer. Try to find some string.
Hey,
hurts when they tear your dreams apart. And every new town just seems to bring you down. Trying to find peace of mind can break your heart. It's a use a friend where the road ends. That's the
so what made you to become a First Blood fan?
Well, for example, for my parents' age, you know, Superman is like their heroes. But however, because I was lived in the 80s, the Rambo became superhero to me after I saw the First Blood. So always, it was always my dream to come here.
So, Matthew, you told me that the first time you watched the movie was in 1986, 4 years after the release.
Yeah.
Would you think that one day you will come to the Delmar property?
No, it seems a bit surreal, really. I've met on the internet people like Regan and obviously you, a filmmaker, and never thought I'd be here, to be honest, a dream come true.
Tell us, Regan, about how you feel to be on the Delmar property.
Well, as I came down the road and I saw the first milestone, which was the tree that in the film, which is on Stallone's right-hand side. And then you see as soon as I saw this tree, I knew I had arrived, and it was my Christmases, my birthdays, all rolled into one.
So you're going to reenact for us the widow scene?
Well, I am a little bit jet-lagged, but I'll try my best. My name is John Rambo. We served on the same team together in Delmar. I don't know if you ever talked about me. As you can see, that's Delmar's writing. I sure had a hard time finding this place. I've got a picture of us together somewhere. It's junk in your pockets. Here it is. It's me. Here it is. Ronson, I'll take, and there's Delmar right in the back. If we didn't hear, it's so big, if we didn't hear, he'd take up the whole picture. Look how big it is.
Delmar's gone.
When? What time will he be back?
He died.
Died? Died how?
Cancer. Brought it back from there. All that orange stuff that spread it around. Cut him down to nothing. I could lift him off the sheep.